Bienvenido, Germain. Lo primero que me gustaría preguntarte, aparte de darte la bienvenida a España, como no, es, seguramente es una pregunta que te habrán hecho 10 millones de veces y la respuesta siempre es la misma, pero a mí me gustaría saber que nos dijeses cuál es el mayor legado que Michael ha dejado al mundo.
First of all, we'd like to welcome to Spain and then ask you something that you maybe been asked like 10 billion times, but what do you think is the biggest legacy that Michael left to the world?
His message.
Su mensaje.
And his message was bringing the world together and us looking at each other as one and not different nationalities, different religions and this and that, but we're all people because we're all on, we share the same planet Earth together. That was his legacy. Through his songs and his music, that's what he was saying, and trying to cure the ills of the world through awareness and, yeah.
Su legado a través de sus canciones y su música fue realmente transmitir el mensaje de que todos somos uno, independientemente de las razas, las nacionalidades o lo que sea. Y realmente lo que él intentaba era sanar el mundo.
¿Se puede sanar el mundo a través de la música, a través de la composición o simplemente a través del mensaje que él exponía con cada una de sus interpretaciones?
Can you really heal the world through music and songs and through every of the performances that he did?
No, you can't heal the world because this world is destined to go where it's going to go, but you can bring an awareness and make people conscious of what they do. Like when you, a lot of products that are biodegradable now be because of just the ecology and the and just being aware of the rainforest and the poaching of animals and the Masai Mara, of the killing of elephants, and these are all things that he cared about. He cared about the planet Earth. Heal the World was just a bringing together of people and making the world realize this is what we need to do. We need to heal the world because it's really crying out for a lot of things now. Global warming, gases, everything.
Realmente no puedes sanar el mundo. Lo que sí puedes hacer es hacer que se despierte en la conciencia de la gente para comprender que todos somos uno y que debemos unirnos a la hora de trabajar en solucionar cosas como la deforestación o el tráfico de colmillos de elefante, ese tipo de cosas. Y todos juntos sí que podemos conseguir sanar el mundo.
A lo largo de la historia, todos los medios de comunicación a nivel mundial han escrito, han dicho y han publicado muchísimas noticias sobre Michael, unas llenas de verdades, imaginamos, y otras llenas de mentiras. ¿Han publicado más mentiras? ¿Han publicado más verdades? ¿Y cuál es la mentira que más le ha dolido a la familia?
Through the years, media has published and written so many and said so many things about Michael. Some were true, some were false. Were there more lies or more truths? And what was the lie that hurt more your family?
Well, first of all, you got to understand the media. They don't have a job unless they sensationalize something and blow it out of proportion. And it's called a lie. And at the same time, we know where we come from. We know who we are. We were raised the right way. And for the media to do these things, it's because they have self-gain, which means they sell papers. I can bet you billions and billions of dollars were made before Michael died. Then after he died, it was more billions made because this is what they do. So we don't get caught up into that. We stay focused on what we need to do, why we were put here to entertain. And I wrote a book a few years ago called Through Michael Through a Brother's Eyes, which was to clear up a lot of these misconceptions and things that were written and books that were written that were unauthorized. That means not by, we didn't approve of these books because people or out to tear apart something that was, it's like this. Our family's close, and we're a family. And Hollywood and the media looking for any little thing to tear it apart. So that's who we are. We're a family, and we will always be.
Lo primero que hay que hacer es entender a los medios de comunicación, y los medios de comunicación actualmente lo que intentan hacer es vender a toda costa y utilizar el sensacionalismo para ello. Entonces se han dicho desde luego muchas mentiras, muchas cosas erradas y que no eran del todo ciertas sobre nosotros y sobre Michael. Y se han escrito muchos libros no autorizados, así que yo hace unos años escribí un libro, Michael, a través de los ojos de un hermano, para poner orden en todo esto, aclarar los malentendidos, porque en Hollywood lo que se intenta hacer siempre es dividir y causar desorden, y nosotros sabemos muy bien quiénes somos y de dónde venimos, y por eso no perdemos esto de vista y nos mantenemos unidos como familia hasta el día de hoy.
So you can't believe what you read.
No, uno no puede realmente creerse todo lo que lee.
Si yo te mirase ahora a los ojos, que te estoy mirando, pero con las gafas no te veo demasiado bien, me gustaría que nos contases cómo ve, a través de los ojos de Germaine, cómo ve Germaine a Michael.
If I could see direct into your eyes something I can't do because you have your sunglasses on, I would like to know, how do you see Michael through your eyes?
Michael's my brother. He was raised the same way I was, and the rest of my brothers and sisters were. I see him as a person who was a big kid at heart, who never grew up, who loved elementary things. So do I. All my brothers, we love kids. We love having fun with kids, going to theme parks and going to water parks and playing baseball and things like that. So the world look at that as a problem, but the world is a problem to start with. But something that's so clean and pure, they make it ugly. And so he would never do anything to hurt anybody. His whole thing is to bring love and joy to people. That's the way we are too. So. You can't listen to what the world says and media, like they paint my father out to be this bad person, and he's not.
Pues Michael realmente era un hermano como cualquiera de los otros hermanos. Recibió la misma educación, crecimos juntos, nos peleábamos como cualquier hermano, nos lo pasábamos bien, hacíamos bromas, nos gustaba ir a parques temáticos, a parques acuáticos, y Michael siempre mantuvo vivo el niño que tenía dentro. Por eso le gustaban las cosas sencillas, y a mí me sucede lo mismo. Se han dicho muchas cosas horribles sobre Michael, pero él era una persona tan limpia, tan transparente, tan pura, que jamás podría haber hecho daño a nadie. Es una cosa de algunos medios de comunicación que han intentado dañarnos, igual que han dicho cosas horribles sobre mi padre que no son en absoluto ciertas.
Lo que sí que es cierto es que te hemos visto en el patio de butacas y hemos visto tu mirada, una mirada dulce, una mirada risueña, con muchísima melancolía, cuando los bailarines, los músicos, los cantantes estaban aquí interpretando y haciendo este gran homenaje muy merecido a Michael. Cuéntanos, ¿qué es lo que sentías cuando estabas visionando todo lo que sucedía en el patio de butacas?
You were sitting watching the show, and we could see you move in your seat and be moved by the show. What were your feelings when you were seeing all these dancers and singers perform the songs of your brother?
It's exciting because Michael has great music, and I made a few notes that I think that would make things a bit better, but I think with every opening of any show, any performance, you practice so much, but it's different when the crowd is there. And so they're all going to feel that they could have did this or they could have did that, but I think the crowd is going to love it. They're going to enjoy it because everybody's given their all. The guy who plays Michael's great. Caroline, Carlene is great. The dancers are doing their part. The band is doing their part. So I think it's all going to work out.
creo que va a funcionar muy bien este show porque las canciones de Michael son maravillosas y he podido ver unos bailarines increíbles, la banda también, todo el mundo hace su parte, pone toda su energía ahí. Carlin es una cantante extraordinaria y lo que he hecho algunas anotaciones a la banda porque bueno, se ensaya, pero cuando uno se pone delante del público, pues siempre piensa, podría haber hecho esto así o esto otro mejor, pero estoy seguro de que el estreno va a ser un éxito y que a la gente le va a encantar.
Ya para acabar y poner un poquito la guinda al pastel, ¿crees que si Donald Trump escuchase muchísimo más a Michael Jackson no diría tantas estupideces como dice?
Would you say that if Donald Trump would listen more to Michael's songs, he wouldn't say as many stupid things as he says?
I agree. It starts with The Man in the Mirror, that song first. But that's who the American people chose.
Bueno, I didn't, pues. Sí, estoy de acuerdo totalmente en que le iría mejor si escuchara más las canciones de Michael, empezando por Man in the Mirror. Pero bueno, es lo que los americanos han elegido, aunque yo no lo he elegido.
Thank you very much. Muchísimas gracias.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.